This is Maya. Welcome to Jog Bay.
Good morning. Yeah, it's another nice, cool November morning here at Shark Bait, Huntington Beach, California. Today, I wanted to briefly go over something we probably should have discussed, maybe 6 months ago, but did not, because the product was not fully available at that point in time. We're talking about the Avet MX Series Star Drag Reels. Kind of a little interesting history on these pieces. Yeah, Harriet Avet had designs on these, as well as a spinning reel, as well as a level wind, back in the early 2000s, but did not go into production. A couple of years ago at ICAST, Avet showed a picture of a Star Drag reel, and this was after Okuma introduced the Tesoro product, and at the time, same time, that Accurate introduced their Star Drag, the Turn. So Avet wanted to go ahead and jump into that fray, and so at ICAST that year, they had basically it was a photoshopped version of what the reel would look like. And then, approximately 8 months or so later, Avet introduced their MX Series Star Drag reels. And that would give us an MXL, the wider version, as well as the MXJ, the skinnier. Yeah, you could say jigging version. Yeah, a lot of us like the narrower spools from a casting standpoint and level wind, leveling that line as it comes back into the reel being narrower. It's a little easier to level it out. And from a line capacity standpoint, it may or may not be useful to have the wider spool. The MX series can give us a good 500 yards plus. Of 50-pound braid, for instance, on the L size. Now, that may be more than what's required, depending upon the line test you want to be fishing. But interesting reels. And again, they weren't the first on the market with the re-emergence of Star Drag reels. Avet was known more for their lever drags that could spin. That was the innovation when they hit the market, with lever drags that had the ability of spinning well without being hot rodded by someone else, Cal Sheets did with pin reels and others. So, that's kind of the background. Now, initially, Avet's plan was to produce the MXL first, then the MXJ, and then both of those pieces with the casting control, the magnetic cast control, which is a wonderful feature to have on something you're tossing a lot. And that's what they apparently have done. We've gotten the MXLs and the MXJs now. The MC versions will be the ones coming next. And we've got a few customers that have been sitting with an open order for those pieces, wanting them, but Avet had not produced and has not produced them as of this moment in time. But that will be overcome here pretty shortly. Let's look at the reels a little bit, because they are nicely done. This is the MXL size, and this is the skinnier J version. Let me bring them up a little bit closer. So the J is skinnier, the L is wider, okay? Both really, really nicely done. And from a fit and finish and machining standpoint, these pieces are really, really nice. Avet did a beautiful job with the machining. I would say they're really along the lines of, the G2, the second generation version reels from Avet. And the first thing that I kind of looked at and noticed was overall comparing this to my MXL Raptor that I own, and very similar. The gear housing is not oversized, which on first glance tells me the gear is not big. And that would be the one criticism I've had on my MXL. I guess I've got two criticisms on my MXL Raptor. Love the piece for fishing up to, say, 40-pound lines, and that's where I generally will fish that Raptor. But realistically, it's a 6 and 4, so low's not as low as I might want for a bigger tuna on that Raptor piece. And from a cranking power standpoint, my belief, and again, I'll get Sturgy in here later, is that we don't have quite as much cranking power as we would if we had a bigger gear. In my way of thinking, still the nicest star dregs on the market would be Daiwa's Saltigas, and they're priced like it, but beautiful machining and wonderful execution. You know, the Tesoros from Okuma have been exceptional reels, and the Terns also are getting a lot of play. A lot of guys like that 600 narrow as a Wahoo piece. Spins fast, casts great, and it has plenty of drag. So that's the environment in which these pieces came. From a machining standpoint, top drawer stuff. From a functional standpoint, very, very nice reels. Observation again, from spooling them up and shipping out quite a few, is that the drag level could be greater, in my opinion. I think the manufacturer is stating a good 15 pounds worth of drag, and we'll double check that spec to be sure I'm not blowing smoke. Okay, from a drag standpoint, Avet is claiming that these will do up to 20 pounds worth of drag. Now, what I will say is that we're not seeing that. And accurate, similarly, when they first came out with the reels, we're not producing up to 30 pounds worth of drag they were claiming initially. That has improved, but the reality was they weren't hitting that spec. On a star drag reel, you can button them down. So when in spooling, we were saying maybe we're getting up to maybe 15 pounds worth of drag. Well, that's appropriate for, say, 40-pound line, but it's not 20. So I contacted Avet and spoke to Harry about that and asked him if that was just something that we were seeing or if that's where they were. And was told that basically that's going to increase drag over time as the surface area of that drag washer gets smoothed out from pressure. And you'll be able to go ahead and, rinse that star down and you'll gain that drag that you're looking for. And, maybe so. Certainly, if you crank the star down, you are going to get more drag out of it. But we're not hitting, 26 pounds of drag, like maybe a pin Baja Special, the old Baja Special, the 113 metals do. These days we see a lot of reels with more drag than they need. It's almost like the wattage wars and stereo gear, 20, 30 years ago. Drag needs to be appropriate for the line test being fished. A little bit above that, so you've got some headroom. That's good. But, reality is these have enough drag for the line they're made to fish. The MX series, as far as how many yards per crank you bring in, is not a super, high-speed reel. It's not the piece you're going to be using for Wahoo bombs necessarily. You won't bring in enough line per crank for that application. The hope would be this would be a great piece from a casting standpoint to put on the jig stick. Now, operationally, these guys are a little bit different. This is not a drag adjustment, this knob right here. That is not for adjusting drag or anything else. It is, on most reels, has been used as a centering adjustment for the spool. And so you'll loosen it so you've got free spool, and that's where you wind up fishing it. Not too loose, not too tight. Avet includes a little note with their reels. And this one, I want to read to you, clearly. And it says, important at the top. The spool end play knob, which is what this little silver knob is, must be adjusted properly by turning it clockwise until the spool just begins to lose free spool, free spin. And then back it off a quarter turn counterclockwise from that position. So a little bit on the loose side is where you're going to want that adjustment. Adjusting the knob too loose or too tight can result in damage to the reel. So be careful on that. Do not use it to control the cast. It is not a casting adjustment. It's not a drag adjustment. It's not a spool tension device. It is strictly an end play adjustment and a lubrication port. Every three trips or so, unscrew and remove that knob. Okay, and then apply three drops of any high quality reel oil into the hole and readjust the spool end play. That's how you use this. You don't use it like, the small level wind bait casters. As for example, this would be a more typical, you know, small bait caster, and we do have that end play knob here, and that is something that we are used to using to help match up the spool pressure to the lure casting weight. That's typically how we would use that knob. You put the, you know, have it on a rod, have the lure that you're going to be fishing, and go ahead and put in a free spool, let that lure drop to the ground, and then you adjust that knob until the spool stops once that lure hits the ground. That ain't the way you do it on these guys. Okay, so note that one, and that would be the same, you know, for really any of the star drags out there. Yeah, don't look at that as necessarily being an adjustment for lure weight and casting use as we would for the smaller bait casting reels. Let's look at these guys a little bit more closely. Okay, here's our group of reels. Basically, there are four different variants in terms of color: black and red, gunmetal and silver, silver and gunmetal. That was a pretty easy one for them. And then the blue and silver. So four different colors, and we do have two different widths with the L size and the J size. That's it. As far as machining goes, beautiful pieces. Maybe we can zoom in a little bit and you can get a better idea. Let's go ahead and look at the blue one a little bit more closely. Okay, beautiful little piece. You know, the machining is really excellent. I like the way they've beveled the sides on these pieces. Nicely done, you know, within their line class. And realistically, 40 pound and down, drag wise, it's a beautiful match for 30. Could you do 40? Certainly. Well, some guys do, straight braid and really, bump it up. Yeah, you'll have that too. But overall, nicely done, that reel foot. This is so very, very stable. I was on a boat last week, and one of our clients had a reel that he really just wrenched the doggone thing. It was a machined aluminum reel clamp, put it in, and sure enough, he wedged in there so hard, it was hard to come out, and when it did, reel foots broke on these two reels because they were a cast foot. These are machined on the Avet reels. They're not stamped. It's not basically a cheap piece of steel. They're machined and they're very, very strong, and I've never seen failure on one. Never have. Six bolts attached to the frame. It's very, very robust on the Avet reels. And that's something I'll say overall with Avet reels. They're pieces you can fish hard, and have confidence in. But Mark and Sergey here, I had made a couple of comments regarding the internals of the new Star Drakes from Avet, and also a comment regarding the size of the gear. And really wanted to talk to Sergey a little bit. Maybe I'm on thin ice, maybe not on this one. So what's gonna happen, Sergey's gonna take the piece apart and we're gonna talk about that a little bit. But just off the top, Sergey, you've got the engineering background and I don't. I kind of think the bigger that main gear is, the more cranking power I'm going to have on a bigger fish or dealing with more lead coming up.
Right.
From a physics standpoint, am I on solid ground on that thought?
Right, yeah. The bigger the gear, the easier it is.
Okay, so far I'm good without taking a physics course.
And it depends on passing. What kind of pinion, what the gear ratio is and all that. But a bigger gear is easier. You got
all things equal. Right. If I've got less torque to turn. Now, in terms, we'll open up the MX Star Drag in just a second, but compared to other Star Drags on the market, could you speak to how big that main gear is, or is that one step beyond what we can do right now?
There may be a little bit smaller, but it's not a huge difference.
Compared to, say, a Tesoro Okuma, that seems like it's
Tesoro
got a big gear.
A little bit bigger, but again, it's not a huge difference.
I mean, and how about an accurate Valiant by comparison? Would that have a bigger?
The Valiant should have a bigger one, but it's a lever drag reel, so it's.
Okay, so a Turn would be the right comparison. Sorry.
I believe the Turn is probably similar size as well. Difference in design, can make a bigger difference as well than just gear size.
And a die with Saltigo, we really can't speak to.
It's a little bit. Mine's probably a little bit bigger. far as the actual gear size.
So gear size, so we're coming to a thought that maybe we've got a little difference in terms of the gear size itself. You know, and then the question is, okay, how's the rest of the construction of the piece? And so we'll look at the internals a little bit for that part of it. You know, and we'll go from there. Okay, can we point out some of the internals on the little MXJ Star Drag? Like, for instance, the anti-reverse system on these guys. How does that work?
So on the Star Drags, you actually have an anti-reverse bearing, which is, you know, quite large for a reel of its size, as well as an anti-reverse dog, you know, like their lever drag series, as well as other ones. It's a little bit different in design, but, you know, similar in structure.
So it's a single dog, not a double dog.
A single one. You can see there's another, you know, piece on the side. That's not for a second dog. That's for lefty reels. So they use the same frame for a left-handed reel. That way they can just flip it to the other side, just like the lever drags as well.
Oh, okay. So a single dog, as well as a one-way anti-reverse bearing.
Right. So the one-way bearing is, you know, that's going to be your main one, and then as well as a dog for, you know, backup. And then this is the main gear of it, you know, as well as the drag that's inside.
Okay. And the drag on the inside, we've got another picture of that shows multiple elements.
Yeah.
On those washers. Okay. And then by comparison, if you could, how does that look versus, say, a turn from accurate? Yeah, can we do a little comparison to that piece?
I could take a look at it here. This is a turn 500 size. So you have, you know, a fairly big difference as far as the gear design. You know, same kind of cutouts for your drag to, you know, to get extra drag pressure. But then obviously the turns have another drag plate on the other side.
That's why it's so thick.
Right, it's much thicker, so it's, you know, wow, probably 40 or 50% thicker than the Avet gear, just because you have another drag washer on the other side that's squeezing. So that's why you also have a shaft that's going through the main, you know.
Now, are they both using ear drags? I see the cutouts there.
Yeah, so that's just to keep it from, you know, turning inside of it. They're not, you know, on some reels they're glued inside like some of their lever drags, but on this they're just, they have tabs that keep it from spinning.
Okay, and same on the Avet. And then on the anti-reverse for the Accurate, what do we have to work with there?
I mean, you have this a large anti-reverse bearing as well, and they've, you know, designed that themselves.
Does it have dogs as well?
That's a good question. It looks like no, it does not. So, look at that. No dogs on this one.
Okay, so.
But you've got, you know, a pretty large and, you know, custom made and a reverse bearing, which is nice to see as well.
Yeah, certainly they've been a lot more reliable since they upgraded that bearing, on the Accurate reels. That's been the big difference over the last, you know, 10 years, 5 years with Accurate, and why their reliability has gone up. So all in all, the Avet looks pretty doggone good.
They've got some nice design features. I mean, another thing that is kind of easy to overlook, they have similar to kind of like a free-floating spool design, so the shaft does not actually go all the way through, like on the turn or many other Star Drags. So the way a spool tensioner works, let's say this actually goes all the way through the bearing, and on the other side you have a little, you know, piece of graphite or plastic that, you know, tensions it, you know, slows the spool down. Yeah. On this, it's a free, you know, quote unquote free floating kind of spool design that other reels have, you know, we've seen on some really high end bait casters and some other Star Drag reels, but it's been around for a very long time. So you actually have a pin that'll go through the pinion bearing. So this is not really a spool tensioner, it actually just centers the spool, because you've got much better free spool on this one versus, let's say, if it had a shaft that went all the way through. So it's a slightly different design. That's why they're coming out with a MC version, so a cast control version. So that's going to be taking care of that versus a spool tensioner.
You mentioned on disengaging, kind of like the Daiwa.
Daiwa has
SLs a little bit.
Similar, yeah. We've seen, you know, some of their really high-end bait casters will feature a similar design, as well as the, you know, sea lines and other reels as well.
Great. Well, thank you for taking them apart. Now, good luck putting them back together.
Yeah.
But I think that helps. Good enough. Thank you, Sergey. So as Sergey works to put our demos back where they belong in the case and put back together again so they still spin, you know, I guess that will be checking off for us. Yeah, I hope this video has been helpful, and certainly check back. We have a number of other little projects we want to get done over the wintertime and get posted on our channel. Thank you again for watching. Mark and Sergey out.